All right, so lesson 2.2, we have a little bit of vocab for you guys to write in. We're talking about combined inequalities. So if you take simple inequalities and you combine them, you're going to have a conjunction or a disjunction. So if you want to pause and just write this in, a conjunction is a compound statement formed by joining two statements with a connector and. And a disjunction is a compound statement formed by joining two statements with a connector or. So you might remember compound inequalities from algebra 1, the ands and the ors. And so that's what we're talking about. We can call them combined inequalities. We can call it a conjunction and a disjunction, just more vocab for us to know. Let's take a look at just a couple examples or a few examples of these compound or combined inequalities. So this first one, it says x is less than 2 and, so that's what makes it the conjunction, x is greater than or equal to 1. So what you want to notice is this is solved for x and this is solved for x. So that means that we're ready to graph it. I need a 1 and a 2 on my number line. And it says x is less than 2. So here's my open circle on 2. Less than means it's going to shade to the left. And then x is greater than or equal to 1. So greater than or equal to, we fill in our circle. And it's going to shade to the right. So you might remember there are inequalities where everything in between your two values was shaded. That's an and inequality. All right, a disjunction is going to be the or. So again, they're both solved for x. So we're ready to graph this. I need 0 and 1 on the number line. It says x is less than 0. So open circle, less than, shades to the left to the smaller numbers. Or x is greater than or equal to 1. So we fill in our circle. And then greater than 1 are all the numbers bigger than 1 to the right. So if you notice, an and inequality shades in between your two circles, an or inequality shades out. And one way to remember that the ors shade out, it's like the ors on a boat, you know, a rowboat that you're going to row. So ors always shade out. All right, last example here. Now this one doesn't tell us if it's an and or an or, but just, you know, get a feel for what this looks like. We have three sections here, your left, your middle, your right. This is an and inequality or a conjunction. We're not ready to graph this because this x has a 2 and a 5 with it, so we want to solve for x in the middle here and get that x by itself. So first thing we're going to do is subtract 5. Well, if we subtract 5 on the left, you have to subtract 5 on the... Sorry, if we subtract 5 from the middle, you have to subtract 5 from everywhere, left and the right side. Your 5's cancel. 3 minus 5 is negative 2, is less than 2x, which is less than or equal to 10. And now go back to the middle where the x is. To get rid of the 2, we have to divide by 2. And you just have to remember, divide by 2 everywhere. Your 2's cancel. This leaves you with negative 1 is less than x, which is also less than or equal to 5. So this is an and inequality. We can go ahead and plot on our number line a negative 1 and a 5. I do oftentimes like to show where 0 is on the number line when we're doing these compounds, so 0 would be right there. We have an open circle at negative 1 because this inequality next to the negative 1 is a less than, so that's going to be an open circle. And then we have a closed circle at 5 because the inequality with the 5 is an or equal to, so we fill that in. Now we can just remember that this is an and inequality, so it tells us we're going to shade in between both. If you were to break this up, first look at this. X is less than or equal to 5. So here's 5. You can see we're shading everything less than. And then if you look at the right, we have to read it backwards. If you start with the x, x is greater than negative 1. So here's negative 1, and see how we're shading the greater than side. So this is a common way that we see the and or the conjunction compound inequalities. All right, now it's time for a song. I feel like I'm picking the most random songs for my music collection, but that's okay. Let me know if you know this one.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line, engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty except for one man still.